right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Dojo here on Raid Select. I am Jeff.
I am also Jeff.
Good. All right. It's double Jeff day on the Dojo, everybody.
Little Jeff on Jeff action.
And we're playing Amplitude today, which, Amanda, do you know anything about Amplitude?
I know that it's like a rhythm game.
Yes, it is indeed.
That's all I know.
Okay, well, we're going to play the campaign. This is actually a game that was kickstarted last year. Okay, difficulty. I can go with that. Which
you
nano blaster?
Uns or your wub wubs?
Chubs,
or
boxy, shogun. Okay.
I don't know what any of that means, but let's go with
all right,
Raven.
Fine. Yeah. Oh, shit. What are we doing here?
Are we having brain surgery?
Is this the new What is it saying? Perfect brain?
That's the perfect brain.
It's the perfect brain.
Okay.
So okay. Okay.
Right. Okay, got it.
Well, this is not the kind of surgery that I remember.
Yeah, this is
The doctor normally does this when I go in.
He's skip the tutorial when your doctor's talking about your brain surgery?
Yeah.
You're like, skip.
Yeah.
Just skip it.
Yeah,
it's
just
fine.
Skip it. No.
I'll figure it out when we get there.
I'm like, this is my kind of doctor, you know? Tutorials are for jerks.
What? This looks like the thing that comes up before a movie plays. Do you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, welcome to the Cinemark. Please silence your cell phones. Concessions are available in the lobby.
Yeah, wow. You've been to the theater recently.
Well, sure. I had to see Star Wars like 6 billion times.
I've only seen it once. I'm a failure.
I really enjoyed it more the second time that I saw it. So, yeah, I don't know if you've ever played one of these before,
no.
But like, I would kind of consider them to be like failures of rhythm games. Like, it was honestly, this is like Harmonix's. This is a sequel to Harmonix's first game, but it's just way less engaging because there's only 3 buttons.
What does the line in between them all mean?
What's that?
Which See how line? There's like a little tiny line that's connecting these?
Oh, it's just to show you which one to hit next.
So they think you're dumb?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I thought it was like a holdy down thing.
No. As near as I can tell, there is no holdy downiness. There's some secret special powers, but oh shit.
Oh,
see,
today's the day we're going to learn that I don't have any rhythm.
That's all right. You can always blame it on the calibration.
It wasn't calibrated. The shadow boxes weren't together. I also have never taken hallucinogenic drugs before.
Oh, they're so awesome.
Which might also affect my ability to play this game, it looks
you're
like.
Not, you're not feeling the music?
I'm
I was like,
not,
oh, bro, I could feel it.
Did they show me the perfect brain so I know when my perfect brain has melted
That's
into
right.
this?
That's right. So that when you're doing the mescaline, you can compare your MRI to the MRI on the television and see, yeah.
How do they know I just have an MRI?
Well, doesn't
available?
Everybody?
Well, I assume
just,
so.
It's an app these days, right? You just download the MRI app for your iPhone.
Yeah.
You just hold your cell phone
See,
up to your head.
See, that's the problem. I'm
Damn
poor.
It.
I don't have an iPhone.
Oh. Yeah, it's iOS only, I'm afraid.
Of course it is.
Son of a bitch.
What is happening?
So basically, like, there was actually, it's funny because the, before Rock Band 4, I believe the last Harmonix game that came out was Rock Band Unplugged, which was essentially just this, but with Rock Band.
Yeah.
Instead of like craziness.
Did you just destroy the music?
Yes.
Was that the point?
Well, I was just clearing that particular thing. But I think that I have this personal theory that the enjoyment that you derive out of any rhythm game is based entirely on whether or not you know the songs in the game.
All right. This sounds like some weird bullshit EDM music.
Yes.
And I don't rave.
Yes. Well, neither
see,
do I.
See my prior history with drug use.
Oh.
I don't do the drugs. I don't go to the raves where the drugs are done.
I have to tell you, as a person who has once upon a time been to a rave not on drugs, it is definitely not very fun.
Is it just like good, clean family fun at that point?
No, it's just everybody else around you is on drugs and you're not on drugs. I don't know. You know, if you're really into this kind of music, I suppose going to a rave might be fun if you're not on drugs. I don't really see the point personally. But
if you're like the type of person that can get like lost in the music, man, you
yeah.
just feel it.
Like you own your own teddy bear backpack and glow stick and pacifier, and you're just like,
as opposed to borrowing somebody else's glow stick and pacifier?
Well, you buy them at the rave, right?
I don't know, Jeff. I've never been to a rave.
I've been to garbage.
I've been to like Ozfest, and there's drug use there that I also didn't do.
Boom! So that is Amplitude.
Thanks, everybody.
Yep, there's three buttons, L1, R1, and R2. And it's like, oh, all right, great. So do we go to the next brain?
Did we fix the brain? Are we destroying
here,
the perfect brain?
You play now. You go.
Okay,
it's time
sure.
for it's time for wetware.
Why do I have to do the wetware?
Because...
Oh, good. There's more stuff for me to not know what's going on.
Yeah, if you get like a special power, you can hit the X button to make it happen. That's
neat.
How I blasted that bunch of notes. Yeah, the fucked up thing is that like in my wayward youth... I actually was a big fan of, like,
oh, Jesus.
90s electronic music, like trip-hop and stuff like that, like early drum and bass and stuff like that. This stuff, never. Okay,
like,
are you getting that thing?
I'm so scared. I don't know why. It's just making me so nervous. I failed. Okay, so what the point here is to avoid the fuck out of that person singing.
Just never go to the vocal track. Never activating that vocal track. I mean, like, yeah, if you play the game on hard, it definitely gets way more difficult.
Oh my god, I'm the worst.
Get it, Amanda. You got it. You're 24% complete.
I got nothing.
You're 24%. Get that synth track going on.
Yeah, man.
I feel great about this because it's the first time on Rage Select that I can sit here in judgment of you playing this horrible game.
Why did you pick such a horrible game?
No, it's not. I mean, I'm sure that somebody in the comments is going to be very upset at our apparent just dismissal of...
No, I feel like
EDM.
This game has officially made me a better person.
Hit the X button. There you go. You get one at least.
All right. My head doesn't work this way.
I guess the thing is that, like, there's one thing, you know, as much as, like, Jason and other people will poo-poo on, like, Rock Band, at least in Rock Band you can pretend like you're shredding some mad plastic guitar on stage with Van Halen. As opposed to this, where I'm like...
exactly what I figured playing this kind of music feels like.
Just pressing three buttons over and over
literally
again.
Literally pressing three buttons and then tripping out on drugs, like, the entire time.
Oh, we should get some drugs.
I don't feel comfortable with that, unless we're doing, like, Jeff versus...
Jeff versus drugs?
Jeff versus LSD.
Oh, yeah. And it's been a long time.
I have babysat people on ecstasy before, and that was interesting, but I've never done it myself.
Yeah.
Yeah, just rub my hair, just put your fingers in my hair, is what I got the whole time, which is really weird.
I think, like, the last time, it's been a long ass time since I did any drugs outside of just smoking.
Tylenol.
Yeah, just crushing up a bunch of Advil, freebase it. Tylenol PM sometimes, you know, you take like four of those.
Dang.
Like, yeah, boy.
You're living hardcore. I fucked up so I can make that joke. I hope you all feel happy about that.
Yeah, freebase a little Mountain Dew, just, you know, squirt, squirt, squirt. But I think the last time that I did any, like, for realsies, reals drugs was some ecstasy with my old roommate, and she was babysitting me on my birthday. And it was great. It was, like, cold outside. We were walking around downtown, and I had a big, nice, warm jacket on, and we went to the jazz bar, and I was just like, all right, yeah. So,
how long ago was this?
Probably 10 years.
Jeez.
Probably a while. I mean, you know, it almost feels like once you get to being a certain part of being an adult, it's like, you know, you could go to all the trouble of dealing with oh, no!
Oh, my God.
That was the end of the song!
No.
Do you want to try it again?
Yeah, why not? It's honestly, like, not the way my brain works, so it just doesn't make sense to my head.
Yeah.
Like, my eyes are like, this isn't how things function normally. Oh, I got it. I will never have to worry about hitting any sort of boost.
I could hook up, like, a Dance Dance Revolution pad if you think that would be
how
easier.
How did you know that I'm better at dance dancing?
You know
what the problem is? Is
that?
It's using trigger buttons, and I don't...
You can use different buttons if you want. You
well,
can use
too
the
late
face
now,
buttons
Marty.
If you want.
Like, you made this weird rhythm. You just
what was I saying? Something about
talks only about you doing all the drugs and how you're a bad influence on children.
Right, right. There's that. I am not a role model.
I never said I was a role model.
I'm an idol. That's more my speed. But no, like you think to yourself, well, I could probably like find, like, have you ever? Okay, obviously not, right? But
yeah.
Allow me to explain the process of buying drugs to you, Amanda.
Okay.
It's horrible. Like, your friend knows this guy, and you drive to his house with your money to get some drugs from somebody, and when you get there, like, the guy won't open the door, and he doesn't know you, so you're not allowed into his house. So you gotta sit in the car for, like, a half hour, because your friend is buying drugs off of him, but, like, he doesn't really trust her unless, like, they do some drugs before they buy some drugs.
That sounds horrible.
So you're just sitting out in the car, like, all right. And then there was the massive amounts of money in my youth that I spent on fake drugs. That's great.
Fake drugs?
Well, hey, how do you know that? I mean, you know, when you're buying acid from a dude on a street corner, like, you don't exactly pull out.
Were
like
you
a,
smoking oregano at some point?
No, never did that. But
snorting some baby powder?
No, but I mean, you know, acid is just.
I watched
pieces of
I
paper.
I watched really shitty sitcoms. I know about all the fake drugs.
Oh man, there was one day where my friend wanted to go sell fake drugs to kids to get some money, and I was just like, "We can't do that, man." We bought so many fake drugs, it would just be like the worst. He's like, "But we bought so many fake drugs that we've got like fake drug karma," and I'm like, "It's not how karma works, bro." Hit the X button. Hit the X button. Yeah, they just move your ship around. You just got it all.
I'm a rainbow.
Okay. Actually, no. The last time I did drugs was at it was ecstasy. It was at my friend had a pajama party, an adult pajama party.
That sounds stupid. I would do drugs then.
Okay, so here's the thing. He was like this guy that I worked with. He's in a band. It should have tipped me off, but he's kind of a nerd. And I was like, he was like, yeah, we're having a pajama party. Everybody's gonna come in their pajamas. I'm like, great. So the day of the party, I go out to Sears and buy like a pair of like 60-year-old man pajamas.
I'm going to guess that everyone was in their cachonis.
Yes. And then you get there, and it was just all of the hottest women on the entire world in their underpants. And then there was all this ecstasy there. And so you couldn't, like, take two steps without watching, like, a bunch of 20-year-old people with basically no clothes on making out. And I'm just like, well, I'm glad I look like somebody's grandfather at this point. This is a hell of a party you got going on here.
Yeah, I probably wouldn't have gone if they said pajama party because I'm not.
Oh, hit X.
Six.
Well, I thought, you know, hey, man, you should go socialize with people that you don't know. Whatever. Like, it's a new experience. Go for it. And it wasn't a bad time. I mean, I wish.
Did you make out with a scantily clad 20-year-old?
I wish. Like, I wish that would have been the end of this story.
The next Rage Leg party?
But it's
pajama
not.
Party.
Oh, God. Well, it's like all of the women were basically just wearing lingerie, and all of the dudes were wearing, like,
boxers,
a sleeveless
and a wife beater.
T-shirt and, like, some sweatpants or something like that. Yeah. And I was like, God damn it. Should really tell people.
You had, like, bunny slippers on and a robe.
No, I mean, it was, like, really super tacky, like, plaid. Like I had the dad pajama shirt that has, like, a pocket on it. Like, I'm going to put my pen in it.
Oh, man. Did it have, like, a little sleeping cap that came with it?
No,
like,
but it would not have been out of.
And would you have worn it if it did?
I would have worn it. And then when I walked into that room, I would have been like, okay, I'm going to go put this in my car.
Oh, God. That's at least it wasn't like a sleeping gown. You know what I mean?
Oh, like the big, like, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory thing? Dude, that probably would have been better. That would have been more of a joke, right?
Yeah.
That would have been more just, like, ridiculous than, like, this nerdy dad jammas that I had.
You should have just shown up naked and been like, this is how I sleep. I don't know what you want.
I could have just taken
me.
My shirt off, but in front of all those people? God, no.
They were on drugs. It's not like they would have remembered. Do you remember that one guy at that party that we were all super high at where he took his shirt off? How embarrassing. No one would have cared.
Actually, that sounds exactly like the kind of story that I would hear at the bar for the people that I know now. You remember that one time when we were at that pajama party, everybody was on drugs, and there was that old guy, and he took his shirt off, and he had like a paunch, and he had a big hairy belly, and I was like, oh yeah, I do remember that guy. What was he even doing there? He was so old. Such an old man.
This sounds like it should have happened. Actually, I feel like you would have had a better time if you didn't have a shirt on.
I'd been like, hey, kids.
You would have upped the intensity of everyone's druggy time.
they've been like, oh, are you seeing this guy? Like, no.
So wait, that was the last time you were on drugs?
Probably.
So were you on drugs, super insecure about your pajamas the entire time?
Sort of. At a certain point, I had to basically just give up the ghost of like, I am not going to be making out with anybody this night. So at that point, it was a lot better. I just listened to all their dumb 20-year-old music, which is always way cooler when you're on hella drugs.
Right, because it's meant for hella drugs.
Right, right. It's like in its natural environment.
What did you listen to when you were 20?
When I was 20, it was...
And was it because you were on drugs when you were 20?
No. Let's see. When I was 20, it was past the 90s. So,
like,
it was really...
Post-grunge?
Yeah, it was kind of post-grunge.
So was that like indie rock or what?
No, it was kind of before that. It was mostly trip-hop.
Trip-hop's
my friends
cool.
And I were all hella into like, you know, DJ Shadow and like DJ Spooky and a bunch of bands like that. And also listening to like the third album from that band that was popular in the 90s.
Yeah.
That nobody else has ever listened to.
You know, that one band.
I mean, I was into... I've been hella into They Might Be Giants for a long time. I remember around in the late 90s, I guess, They Might Be Giants had a deal with E-Music, where they would put out unreleased tracks on E-Music.
Yeah.
And I was hella into that, too. So, I don't know. I could probably, if you want to, during the break, I've got like a bunch of CDs full of MP3s that I burned because I was like, oh man, I gotta
save these music forever.
I gotta archive this. I'll never be able to access it again. Now it's like, Spotify, bitch.
Do you remember? Okay, so you know the struggle. I don't know the fan base age if they're all like, when I was 14, I listened to MP3s, but when we were younger, you had CDs in your car.
Yep.
Okay, so you remember having the like folders of CDs, right?
I've got them. I still got them.
I still have like the suitcase lockbox version. Yeah, I still have it full to the brim, alphabetical order.
Like 500 both sides.
Yeah.
And I've got like 6 of those in this house somewhere.
Really?
There's like
one
that was nothing but movies, like actual DVDs. There's one that's like things that I... Here, you can have this next one.
Okay.
There's one that's like DivX movies that I downloaded when that was a thing and burned. I have some honest to God VCDs somewhere. I went to the bootleg anime store and bought VCDs of Gundam movies to play on my PlayStation 1.
Oh man, you're so hip and cool.
Streak through barriers to avoid damage. I don't know
what that means.
I don't know what that means either.
I'm going to start with...
You've entered the bloodstream.
Oh, wrong button.
Yes.
I forgot what I was doing.
In fact, I used to have that thing that nobody has anymore where my car was just like, it was just full of loose CDs.
Yeah.
They were just everywhere because I didn't give a fuck. I was like, whatever.
So this is the benefit of dating John is that my car, which previously was not full of loose CDs, is now totally full of loose CDs because he has all these old like pop punk bands that he listens to.
Yeah, I know. You guys added a bunch of that Spotify playlist.
We did.
Because I was listening to it, and then I came to one song, and I was like, this is John, isn't it? And I was like, yup.
Okay, first of all, he added a bunch of songs that were from my playlist, and I was pissed that he got credit for that.
By the way, folks, if you go to Facebook or Twitter, I added like a publicly editable Spotify playlist, and like in a day, it went to like...
540
hours or something like that. Like, just a shitload. So now I just put it on shuffle and check out what you people are into. Yeah. I'll give every song about 60 seconds and then be like, no.
Whoever's adding the like hardcore rap is my hero. Like, who looked at Jeff and was like, you know what he really wants to listen to now? I know you're saying you listen to trip hop now, but my instinct would not be like, let's get Jeff into some hardcore rap.
There was a time where I was into some hardcore rap. Never with any credibility, mind you. There's this one back when it was there was this one label that we used to listen to pretty much everything that they came from, and then they divided some of their artists off into a sub hip hop label called Soul Sides. And there's a Soul Sides Greatest Bumps double disc thing that is probably my favorite hip-hop album of all time. It's got like a shitload of great music on it. I J-Rid the Damager, Wu-Tang Clan. I like Dr. Octagon, but not much else that Cool Keith has ever done. And there was a time after GTA San Andreas came out that I started listening to all of the albums that comprised the soundtrack to San Andreas. Is that
the one that's like LA?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I was like, isn't that the movie with The Rock?
There is a movie with The Rock called San Andreas.
No, because that can't
be
right.
Because that's the San Andreas fault, right?
Yeah, but the city in Grand Theft Auto is fake, right? San Andreas isn't a fake place, right?
It is not a fake place in theory. I don't... Maybe.
Okay. I don't know. I've been hypnotized. I think they're programming us here. Do you feel the desire to kill your boss?
I'm not going to answer that right now.
I do.
But I'm nodding my head yes. But Jeff, you're your own boss.
It's so strange. This game is like, kill your boss. I'm like, okay, wait a minute. This seems like a bad idea, game. I don't... your Manchurian Candidate programming has gone off the rails.
You know what this music reminds me of?
What's that?
Playing laser tag with people when I was like 12.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Why?
Because they they played this kind of crazy ass music, and then all the neon lights and shit would be going
on. Talking about like at the laser tag place. I thought you were talking about just like straight up playing.
No, not like buying the cheap ass laser tag stuff.
Like out in the street, I'm like, did you guys all listen to the same techno album when you're out on the street shooting laser tag at each other?
Yeah. Did you ever like religiously listen to a certain song when you were playing a video game, and now whenever you hear that song, it reminds you of that video game?
What? Wait, what is going on here?
Drugs.
Am I supposed
to
be
in the bloodstream? Clearly,
in the musical.
Jeff, were you not paying attention? The story is so in depth, and you can't even focus on it.
This is a rage like thing where they're like, I can't believe you guys are not paying any attention to the story. Like what? Sedate. Deployed a temporary slow perception of audio data.
This whole thing is just a way more complicated version of Dr. Mario.
Sort of. Actually, I just last night... Oh, the temporal lobe now.
Tell me when we get to the Abdullah Oblongata.
The Medulla Oblongata?
No! Yeah.
Oh, the Paula Abdullah Oblongata. Okay.
Well, that's... Yeah, music.
Okay, right.
My foot fell asleep. Yeah, this sounds right. See, I was
let's pay attention to the music for a second here.
I already regret this decision.
All right, let's stop paying attention to the music for a second here.
No, it's like it's fine. It feels like it should be in the like background of a Tekken game or something.
Right.
Like, it doesn't feel like I should be focusing on it as much as this game requires you to. You know what I mean?
Have you ever been a fan of electronic music at all?
I don't hate any kind of music.
Right.
I've never actively listened to techno music. The closest I get to is like, what do they call it? I forget. Nick was really into it. I introduced him to a couple of bands that do it too. It's like swing electronic music.
Yep.
That is as close as to it as I get.
I forget what that stuff was called. There was this one band that I was into for a little while that did that. Mm-hmm. That had one album like that. I think that the problem is that too much of electronic music sounds like what we're hearing right now.
Yeah.
Like, I've been really... My friends and I were all way, way into, like, Aphex Twin for a while. Mm-hmm. And that was cool because Aphex Twin is, like, legitimately a crazy person.
Right.
That dude makes his own instruments and then creates fucking bizarre things with them. Also, he's got some of the greatest horrible music videos of all time. Have you ever seen the music video for Come to Daddy? Everybody has, right?
I believe I have, but I can't for the life of me remember.
Where he's got like these hot chicks that have his face.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
As soon as you say that, everybody's like, yeah. And I remember because when my friend and I were vacationing, when we went to Europe, we used to stay up late and watch the Amsterdam Music Channel, mm-hmm. The Amsterdam version of MTV, and they played that. They had like a call-in show where you could like request a video, and it was automated, right? So nobody was actually paying any attention to it.
Yeah.
So when that when that was a popular song, it just ended up being played over and over and over. And the thing is that the video for that song has like a 6-minute intro of these two guys talking, these two gangsters talking before the Richard D. James limo pulls up.
Yeah.
And I fucking hate the beginning of that.
You're like, skip the beginning.
Yeah. Because just this guy, like, just this guy is kind of like wannabe gangsta. And then his friend who just says, I don't give a fuck. That's what he says all the time. And it's like, God damn it. Can we please skip over
that
this
sounds
part?
Like me when I get mad. Like, I just end every sentence with, I don't give a fuck. This is so...
Oops. Yeah, I kind of
Now you know how I feel. Just disappointment. Rhythm and disappointment.
Let's do a Tekra. That was one.
What happened?
I used the
sedative. Gross.
Oh my God, I'm on so many sedatives right now, man.
I feel like that would make it harder because then when it goes back to normal speed, you'd be like used to slow.
Yeah.
No, this is all.
You gotta get ready. We'll check our time over there because part two, yeah, we're playing co-op. Oh, okay. Time does not go quickly when you're playing Amplitude.
Yeah, go figure.
All right, boosh. We should change our ship to something.
Yeah, make it cool.
Change it to purple or
purple
blue
or pink
or something like that. Okay, continue. Okay, I'm
X to continue. Did your controller just give up? Your controller's like, never again.
No, I was trying to go back so that we could. Like, there we go. Chubbs, Boxy, Shogun. We'll go with Shogun.
Yeah.
All right, it's your turn.
Oh, right.
I gotta rack my brain for more stories about
music.
About dance music.
No, I got nothing on dance music. I'm sorry. I can't help you. You picked the wrong person. Oh, wow.
There was this one band called Add N to X that I really liked. That did a lot more like Moog stuff.
I love Moog.
So it's kind of weird because I almost feel like nobody knows the. This is getting a little bit more crazy. Nobody ever seems to have any real. Like when I look over the stuff that people added to that playlist that I put up there.
Oh yeah.
There's like a whole bunch of this electronic music that I'm like, well, surely the internet knows about this stuff and how cool it is, right? And it's no, not really. Or some people do, or apparently they're just keeping to themselves. Like, for all of you out there who think this sounds garbagey, go listen to DJ Shadow's first album, Introducing. I don't necessarily like a lot of the stuff that he's put out since that first album, but that first album is like, the dude spent like 10 years in the basement of this record store, like poring over old albums to put together this just thoroughly incredible trip-hop album. So what do you think is the closest thing that you get to in your musical world, Amanda? If I can attempt to distract you from this.
Like, what's the closest thing I get to...
What we're listening to right now, say.
Well, besides the, like, techno swing music that I was talking about earlier.
Yeah.
Probably...
Like, new wave?
No, I don't really love new wave. I'm trying to think. I mean... Oh, God. I'm trying. It's so hard to think and do this at the same time.
Yeah.
God damn it, Jeff. ask me questions when you're on here. I don't know. I really jump between a lot of stuff. So I do a lot of like Moog. I do a lot of, not a lot. That's a lie.
I feel like we're getting a masterclass in why Jeff talks on the dojo the way that he does. Where you've started like 4 sentences and then just kind of like wandered off.
Right. Well, them. I'm trying to think of like what I listen to, but I listen to like funk and jazz, and then I'll listen to some heavy metal, and then I'll listen to like pop punk. I don't really have a specific thing that sounds like.
Anything
I mean, really,
like, this.
Like funk sounds like this, kind of like techno funk, like or even like Africa Bambaataa and the Zulu Nation. Sound a little techno-y sometimes because it got that sound to it. I don't know if that makes sense.
Okay.
But I don't, this, no. Because I'm a stay at home and chill and listen to music kind of person.
Yeah.
Who chills to this?
I've known a few.
But are they on drugs while they're quote unquote chilling?
Yes.
See, that's the thing. I don't do drugs. I don't even drink that much anymore.
This is true.
I am so boring.
I just kind of wonder, because the thing that's kind of confusing to me about this style of music is that, like, okay, so there's always, no, that's
my
not true.
I ended the song on a failure.
Is that around in the 90s, like in the mid to late 90s, right, this type of music became a thing. Mm. It wasn't like there was 70s techno,
okay,
right?
Okay, no, I lied, because those like 90s pop dancey music stuff, I definitely listen to those.
Like the Prodigy?
Yeah.
Or Chemical Brothers?
Yeah, like kind of, yeah.
But
that shit was on the radio, like regularly on the radio. So yeah, I listened to whatever was on the radio, and that was what was on the radio. But I was a kid then. So those don't even count.
What's
But I don't know the name of the bands.
God damn it.
So Jeff, maybe if you could just give me a list of all of the your favorite music in order while this is going on. Go ahead. Uh-huh.
Okay, well, first is the Ampy Giants. Second is the Beatles. And this probably sounds really horrible to people, but those two switch a lot of times for first and second.
I think it's an unfair question to ask anybody for their favorite anything, because that all depends on mood.
Oh, yeah.
And
well,
day.
We constantly on Rage Select, I have to tell people, like, when we're getting questions for like Sunday streaming, and people are like, "What is your favorite?" And they're like, "Nope, you need to rethink that, buddy."
Yeah, no.
You need to start over again and be like, I don't even mind really long questions where people are like, "If the moon was SpaghettiOs," I don't know why I'm talking like Bill Cosby. That's weird.
I think Bill Cosby would ask, "What would happen if the moon was SpaghettiOs?"
Aw.
I want SpaghettiOs.
Damn it. It's hard to switch.
Yeah, that's my big problem, and my stupid brain not functioning. Can you imagine when we're playing co-op and we're both doing this? We're like, God.
So what's your favorite? Oh, shit.
Yeah, no, I think it for asking people like their favorites is, one, unfair, like I already said, but it's also like, you know, when I'm super sad that day, I don't feel like playing a super happy game or listening to super happy music.
Right.
Or I do, and when I do, this is what I listen to, and that's my, you know what I mean? Like, there's so many different scenarios for everything.
So I think the thing that I was saying, right, is that this type of music, or I kind of consider this to be, there's nothing exceptionally, like, offensive about what's going on here. It's just not really my bag.
Yeah.
But like this style, like electronic music, kind of started in the 90s, and then it just kind of went away entirely. Like it got integrated into the background of like Black Eyed Peas songs and you know, pop stuff. But as a standalone thing, I mean, I know that there's people out there that are still making it. I'm not so stupid as to say that that isn't a thing.
Yeah, because no genre of music ever actually dies.
Right, but like you said, there was a time when,
where it was like straight up on the radio.
Yeah.
And not like its own radio station, but like,
like 101X was like the, you guys don't know what that is.
Yeah.
The
top 40.
Yeah, the rock and roll kind of like station in this town was playing like Chemical Brothers.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, when I was growing up, the pop stations were playing all the dance music.
Yeah. And, I mean, there was a time when that Orbital track from Trainspotting was like a radio hit-ish.
You know when what it is? You watch any 90s action movie and you'll hear all the dancey dance music, because it all kind of played out in a lot of action movies in the 90s, I think. I'm trying to think of...
Well, I remember, like, you know, when the Dust Brothers did the Fight Club soundtrack, that was like kind of a big deal, right?
Yeah.
And, like, the music from The Matrix kind of had some of that a little bit.
So, like, is the closest thing now as far as popular music just what, Daft Punk?
Probably. Well, I think that, like...
And they're, like, Tron,
you know,
soundtrack?
What? It's dubstep, right?
Is
because
it, though?
That's the
but
closest
dubstep
thing.
Didn't have such a... Not that this kind of music really had a long lifespan on the radio, but I feel like dubstep didn't even... It was, like, a...
It came and it went so quickly.
Yeah, it was super quick. Like, well, it just happened.
I think a lot of that also has to do. Yeah, it also has to do with the fact that mainstream commercial culture was able to absorb dubstep so fast that it went from being like something on the fringe to something some people kind of know about to in the new Toyota commercial to totally dead to Jeff is making jokes about Skrillex and doesn't even know who that is on Rage Select, right?
Yeah.
That's when you know a thing has become super lame is when I'm making jokes about it. Oh, man.
It's like dubstep, right, kids?
You know? It's like Gangnam Style and Chocolate Rain had a baby, am I right? People are like, shut
don't
up, old
ever
man.
Don't say Gangnam
shut
Style.
Shut up, old man.
Seriously, though, Psy is amazing.
Yep.
He's an artist.
Oh, I saw him do the like shot video or something. That was great. Where he was doing all these different like weird shots.
Really?
Yeah. It was crazy. Somebody linked to it on Facebook and I saw it. I think we're probably out of time, though.
Yeah, probably.
Let's see here.
Good. That's what I need. You just to step over everything.
That's what I'm doing, so you better get used to it. But yeah, we are done. So if you're watching us on YouTube, hit the like and subscribe button. Also, you can tell us just how old and out of touch I am with modern music.
I am also old.
I have absolutely no problem with that whatsoever. Hit the like and subscribe button. If you'd like to see these videos a day earlier, you can always head on over to RageSelect.com. We got all kinds of good stuff. Retry.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
If you want to buy this game, no, probably not.
You might if this they is, like
well,
this music.
No. This is a PSN game, so I'm pretty sure that there's not going to be. I'm not going to be able to put an Amazon link to this. But
there
if
will
you,
be an Amazon link at the bottom.
Well, no, there won't. But if
not
you do
for anything, just random.
Well, I could just put like what Amazon Hero. Links to. Yeah, Guitar Hero Live.
Different harmonics game, I guess.
Rock Band 4.
There you go.
Anyway, if you do want to buy something off of Amazon, find one of the Amazon links below the videos on our page, and we get a little cut of whatever you buy. It doesn't cost you anything else. It does help us out. It does help us keep the lights on. If you would like to help us out even further, you can head to patreon.com/RageSelect and basically kick us some bucks every month. In return, we can kick you some bonus videos that nobody else gets to see. Amanda, I have to say that I asked recently some people about what they'd like to see for the next sequential Saturday.
Uh-huh.
Some people said Bloodborne. Some people said Dark Souls 2. I got to tell you guys, John and I have played through all of both Bloodborne and Dark Souls 2 for patrons. Grant and I have played all the way through Asura's Wrath, The Last of Us, as well as a bunch of other things. Jason and I finished out Jazz Punk and played all the way through that Batman... Mr. Freeze, Batman, Arkham Origins. There's a bunch of shit on. Look, there's so many videos on our Patreon list that if I was to start releasing them in place of our regular dojos, this site would still have content for a year. That's 365 days a year.
So you're saying that if somebody were to become a patron,
they would get access
to a year's worth?
A year's worth
of content
additional
that they have not even seen.
Additional content in addition to 3 extra videos every single week. And it is how we keep the lights turned on, how we keep the amplitude flowing, how we keep the hot jams. It keeps us in glow sticks and teddy bear backpacks. So, hey, be a pal. Think about donating $5 a month to Patreon. We would really appreciate it. With that, we're going to go ahead and wrap it up. Tomorrow, we'll be back with part 2, where it's going to be time for co-op. You ready, Amanda?
Not at all. Not at all. All
right.